David and David here. We want to talk to you about some awesome Android battery tips that are going to save you battery life. They really work. And the first one has to do with 5G.
Yep.
Preferred network type.
Yeah, so this is a feature that's not available on every Android. It depends on your carrier. So if you don't see this on your Android, nothing's broken.
Go to the next step.
It's a carrier thing. Timestamps are in the description of this video. So open the Settings app, swipe down, and then swipe down again. Gear, tap that gear. Tap Network and Internet. Tap Mobile Network. And then come down here, Preferred Network Type. Right now it says 5G recommended. I'll tap on that. Now this is kind of depends on coverage in your area. Does your area have good 5G? If it does, maybe you can leave this as 5G. If it's spotty, LTE.
This is a battery video, not a 5G video, but preferred network type is just as much about battery as it is about speed and connectivity. So since LTE is so much more built out than 5G is at this point, it's not only faster, but just having your phone connect to that one network type is gonna save you a lot of battery life. But choose LTE.
I'm gonna tap LTE. And there you go, preferred network type is LTE. Thanks Google Pixel for that one setting.
Yes.
Next, we're gonna talk about some display settings. Here on our Samsung Galaxy S21, I'll swipe down upper right-hand corner of the screen and then tap on the gear icon. Tap on display. The first thing we're gonna talk about is dark mode.
It makes sense. If your screen is darker, it's putting out less power.
Excuse me, Professor Brainiac.
Simple enough, tap dark.
Boom.
There you go. Next, tap on motion smoothness.
This has to do with the refresh rate on your phone's screen. So it can go all the way up to 120 hertz to make things look really smooth. But by default, it's going to be 60 hertz. And for reference, you're watching this video right now in 30 hertz or 30 frames per second. So is it really going to be that much smoother? No. Turn this off, your processor is gonna have to do less work, it's gonna save battery life, and they say it right there.
Yeah, so I'll tap on standard. Get better battery life with 60 hertz screen refresh rate. Tap standard, then tap apply. Next, tap back upper left-hand corner of the screen and come down to lock screen, tap on that. Now we're gonna talk about always on display.
Isn't that a cool feature? It's always on.
Always on,
but
always.
But does it use more battery life?
Yeah, always using battery life if it's always on.
Yeah, my phone gets lonely in my hip pocket.
Yeah, so I'll just tap that switch to turn it off.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Next, let's talk about a permissions issue. If an app has access to your microphone all the time, that means it's always listening for you, waiting to hear your voice, and it's using battery when it's doing that, just bracing for that moment when you say the magic words that make all of our devices go off.
Yes, so like, hey Google.
Yeah. We don't want our devices to be able to do that. So
right. It's also a little creepy sometimes.
Yes.
Did you know that you can actually have apps listening to you all the time?
It's true.
Yeah.
Tap back, upper left-hand corner of the screen. Come down here and tap Privacy. Tap Permission Manager. And then scroll down and tap Microphone. Here you see allowed all the time, Google. No thank you. Just tap on Google. And then, well, you have to deny it.
Deny it. Yep. It's okay to do allow only while using the app, and it's interesting that they don't allow you to do that for this, but I would just, yeah, deny. See you later.
If you deny permission, basic features of your device may no longer function as intended.
Your device.
Device.
Your device may no longer function as intended, Mike.
Yes.
Your device.
Now, if you're not comfortable doing this, maybe you have a Samsung Galaxy and you know, Bixby voice.
Bixby.
Same thing, could be constantly listening to you.
But well, it's not in here.
It's not in here.
Where is it, David?
You have to go into the Bixby app. I'll go back to the home screen and then swipe up, tap Samsung, and then tap Bixby. Tap on the hamburger menu upper left-hand corner of the screen. Tap settings. And then here you'll see voice wake up. Now this isn't on for us right now because we're doing the screen recording using the microphone, but normally this would be on. And this means that Bixby's always waiting to say, you know, hey Bixby. And,
right. Or you're waiting to say it, it's waiting to hear it.
Yes. So just tap that switch to turn this setting off. Next, we're gonna turn off enhanced processing. Theoretically, when this is on, they might get slower, and if that's true, might not be true, milliseconds.
Yeah, you're not really gonna notice the difference here.
So let's go back to the settings app, swipe down, tap on the gear, scroll down, keep scrolling, to battery and device care, tap on battery, scroll down here, tap on more battery settings, and then turn off the switch next to enhanced processing.
Boom.
There you
go. Is it gonna be slower? No.
If it is, you're not gonna notice it.
Right, and if you do, you can always come back with any of these settings, really. It's not like a marriage here.
While we're here in the battery section, let's tap back upper left-hand corner of the screen and then tap on background usage limits and just make sure the switch next to put unused apps to sleep is turned on. Otherwise, your unused apps are gonna be running more in the background, draining battery life.
Yeah, especially because, I mean, when I first got my phone, I downloaded a ton of apps and I don't even use like, you know, 10% of them anymore. So yeah, turn the switch on.
Right to sleep. One good tip when you're having software issues, battery issues, is to make sure your Android is up to date.
When you update the software on your Android, it fixes software bugs. I mean, that's why they do it. So a lot of the time that'll save you a lot of battery life. How do we do it, Dave?
Let's go back to the main page of the settings app. Here we go, back to device care. And scroll down and tap on software update.
Boom.
Tap download and install. It'll check for an update here. And if an update is available, install it.
Do it, send it, full send.
Software's up today. I actually updated this yesterday.
Interesting. Very responsible.
Yes.
Yep. Maybe that's why our phone is so fast. And it has such great battery life.
Absolutely.
Especially subscribing to this channel, also a great battery saving feature. Only 7% of the people subscribe that watch our videos. Please subscribe.
Yep. This one might be a little bit controversial. It's closing out of your apps.
Right. So in a perfect world, you should never have to do this because the software should do it for you. But we don't live in a perfect world, David. Apps do crash. It's a good idea just to close them out every once in a while. It's kind of like wearing a seatbelt in your car.
Yep.
You shouldn't need it, but you'll be glad you did.
Let's tap on the multitasking button down here at the bottom. You've got some apps open. Just swipe these up and off the top of the screen when you're not using them, nice and easy. Get rid of them.
Yep. If one of them was being bad, not anymore. Right into timeout.
But you've closed your apps. They're not going to crash anymore. Let's go back to the settings app and talk about adaptive battery. To get there, tap back to the main page of the settings app. Just tap on battery and device care. Tap battery again. Scroll down and tap on more battery settings. And here you have adaptive battery. Adaptive battery, it limits the battery usage of apps that you don't use often.
Right. It's a great idea to turn the switch right on.
Tap.
Boom. There's so many things that you could change and just really make your battery last longer. It's amazing that these things don't come turned on by default.
Yes, absolutely.
Conspiracy to get you to buy a new phone.
Perhaps.
They're on to me, dude. Those guys are sharp as nails up there. You can't put anything past them.
Similar to some of the display settings we talked about earlier in this video, screen lockout time. If it's set to 10 minutes and you forget to lock the screen, it's going to be on for 10 minutes and it's going to drain some battery life. Where if you set it to 2 minutes, there's
you're limiting the amount of time.
Yes. That is what this setting does. I'll tap back to the main page of the settings app. Come down here and tap on display. Scroll down and tap on screen timeout. Mine's set to 10 minutes right now because we're doing a screen recording. Hypocrite. But 2 minutes, probably enough for most people.
Right. Hypocrite. What's the origin of that word, David?
I don't know.
Hippocrates.
Now, if you're really in a pinch, we don't really recommend doing this on a daily basis because it's probably a sign, if you have to do it all the time, it's probably a sign of a, you know, hardware problem with your battery. But power saving mode will automatically do some of these things, a couple other things to restrict the amount of power your Android is using, save some battery life in the process.
Right. It's not called power spending mode.
Yes. Power saving mode.
Save some battery.
Let's go back to the main page of the settings app. Come down here to battery and device care, tap on that.
I feel like we've been here before, David.
We've been here a lot.
A lot today. I wonder why. It's a battery video. We're in the battery section, people.
Come on. It's like an obstacle course. And then just turn on this switch next to power saving mode. To be specific, this limits background network usage, syncing and location checking, motion smoothness, which we already changed, gets changed to standard. So some of these tips are already baked in to the
set. And we wanted to just let you know the difference between things that maybe you don't want to turn off all the time, which this would do, kind of. This is too much.
Mm-hmm.
It's unnecessary.
You're upset. That's absurd.
But things like motion smoothness, turn those off. You don't need them on.
And those are some Android battery tips. Thanks for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Leave a comment down below with any questions, any tips for us that we might have missed in this video. We can do a follow-up video in a few weeks with some more Android battery tips.
Everybody loves battery tips.
There's a lot in the Android settings app that you can change.
Sure. Yes.
And it's hard to hit on everything in one video.
Yeah.
Impossible. Please subscribe. As we said earlier, only 7% are subscribed. Let's get that number up to 9%.
9%.
Thanks for watching.
Thank you.